Welcome back, students. Today we are going to see what a neural network is in supervised learning. So in the last class we have discussed about the supervised learning. Neural network is the technique of supervised learning. So what a neural network is? Biologically motivated approach to machine learning. What is biologically? Actually it is related to the human body. Neuron is a part of our brain, and neural network is the process which mimics the working style of our brain. So in our brain there are numerous number of neurons are available, and all these neurons are interconnected to each other in order to perform some activity. So what are the functionalities of the neural network? It receives the input from other sources, combine them in some way, and then perform a generally non-linear operation on the results, and at last it will produce the output or the final result. Neural network is massively parallelism allows for computational efficiency, because many neurons are working in parallel. It helps to understand the distributed nature of neural representation, or rather than the localist representation, that allow robustness and the graceful degradation. Intelligent behavior as an emergent property of large number of simple units, or rather than for explicitly encoded symbolic rules and algorithms. So we'll see how these the property of neural network is actually applied in the practical scenario. So what is neural network learning? Because we are studying about the supervised learning or the machine learning. So neural network learning is an approach based on modeling adaptation in biological neural system. As I earlier said to you, that it is a process to mimic the working style of the human brain, which has different neurons interconnected to each other, receive some input, do some computation, and produce the final output. So there are two types of neural network that we are going to see. The first is perceptron. In perceptron, initial algorithm for learning simple neural network, or the perceptron is also known as the single layer neural network, and it was developed in 1950s. Backpropagation is the second type, or the advanced version of the perceptron. It is more complex algorithm for learning multi-layer neural networks, and it was developed in 1980s. Neural network is a set of connected input output units, where each connection has a weight associated with it. So if a neuron X is connected to neuron Y, then there should be some weight between the connecting line. Neural network learning is also called as the connectionist learning, due to the connections between the units. As I have said, that there is connection between the neurons, and the initial neuron receives some input transferred to the next neuron so that the final outcome can be obtained. It is a case of supervised inductive or classification learning. So neural network is the part of our supervised learning. Neural network learns by adjusting the weights so as to able to correctly classify the training data, and hence after testing phase to classify the unknown data. So being a part of this supervised learning, the task of neural network is to classify the given pattern, right? So how the patterns are being classified in neural network? By using the weights. There are weights between two neurons, and we are going to learn these weights by doing the revised computation, And after adjusting this weight, we are going to build a model, and this model is used in the testing phase in order to classify the unknown data, right? Neural network needs long time for training. Obviously, there are numerous number of neurons are connected in a network fashion to each other, so it will take some time in order to learn the weight and build the model. Neural network has a high tolerance to noisy and incomplete data, because this support can be obtained from other neurons, like each neuron is connected to the other neurons also. So if there is some missing value or some incomplete data is available, that can be available by other neuron connected neurons. What are the advantages? Prediction accuracy is generally high, robust, works when training examples contain errors. Output may be discrete, real valued, or a vector of several discrete or real valued amplitudes. So output can be in any other form. Fast evaluation of learned target function. So what are the disadvantages? Long time training. Numerous number of neurons are there, so training will be tough. Difficult to understand the learned function weights. We have to learn these weight by repetitive supervised learning approach. Not easy to incorporate domain knowledge. So the basic neural network is actually dependent upon the domain area, right? So you can not say that this particular neural network model can be applied in any other domain also. So these are some of the basic theoretical introduction about the neural network. We will see the other things and advanced version of neural network in the next lecture. Thank you.